2 minutes till we're starting. So, there's that. The test stream was perfect. And that's what I'm saying. It did. I don't know if Carlson has the technical expertise to fix the echo. We're good now. I have 4 people saying it's good. Echo gone. Hammer's technical abilities under serious question. Yeah, okay. I'm wearing a suit because I want to class up the streams a little bit. So I made this kind of sarcastic post before the tournament about not making fun of Danny and so on and so forth. And the making fun of Danny part, I did lie about. The suit part, I did not. So that was a little competition there going. GM technician would not have had the trouble to start with. So, but thank you. I did manage to fix it in 15 minutes. I think any tech job I had would... yeah, I would be fired quite quickly. More hats? Yeah, I don't know what that means. Learn something from Simon. I do actually have a very nice picture with a cowboy hat on Google. So if you Google me, there's a really nice echo. No, you're kidding me. Echo again? Okay, the game started. So I'm gonna not care too much about that one guy saying there's an echo and focus on the game. It's a con Sicilian, which I really don't know anything about. Let's do this move. Okay, so there's no echo. Everything seems to be fine. We're playing chess. And we're playing a guy I don't know much about. Cannon. Yeah, I don't know this guy. There's supposed to be some kind of trick in this opening in which I threaten the black queen with my bishop. This is probably not the moment. Let's play the rook. Yeah, so I did say something about whispering in my preview blog post. I was only slightly serious about that. What else have I promised? Yeah, I'm really looking forward to the game with Danny. I think that's going to be the highlight of the tournament. And I have no idea what to do here. Somehow I thought the chess part was going to be the easiest. Okay, I'm going to take this knight, and then I'm going to play this knight to a4, thinking about going here to b6, so he's going to play his rook to b8, and then I'm going to play my pawn in the center, because you can never have too many pawns in the center. Okay, he didn't stop me. Do I want this bishop? Yeah. How am I on time? I'm playing a bit slow, actually. Yeah, but I got a bishop, so I'm not too afraid. He's gonna come out with his bishop here. Then I'm gonna move my rook. I don't think that was too clever. I'm gonna threaten this pawn down here, and then I'm gonna challenge in the center. Where am I? I don't think I'm playing that well. But it's not only beginning. Okay. I'll take this pawn. In general, whenever there's a pawn to be taken, yeah, you don't have to ask me twice. How are we for... Wow. 130 viewers. I should maybe try to promote something. Maybe make a move as we go. A good one, preferably. Let's not do that. Let's do this move. That was a good move, actually. Basically by accident. Getting at the queen and the rook. He's gonna have to play. He can play queen c8. But he's gonna have to play his queen somewhere. And then... Well, I'm a pawn up. So I should be fine. Yeah, this was the one I was hoping for. Because now I get to exchange the queens while the bishop is going down the diagonal. So I got my pawn into play. And... Yeah, I should win that somehow. I can continue my queen. And now I'm gonna play real fast soon. Because I'm a bit low on time, but I'm a pawn up, so there's that. I have a feeling some of the other guys had easier games. Okay, but I have two passed pawns supported by a bishop pair. If I don't win this, that would be something, wouldn't it? I did mute. Will I do other streams? Yeah, I think I'm gonna do other streams. Maybe more likely if this one goes well, or you know, if I don't mess up completely the whole technical aspect of things. But I thought about the candidates. No, not the candidates. The World Cup semi-final, which is basically the last. Obstacle before you qualify for the candidates, and I thought about maybe I should stream a bit there. So yeah, I'm definitely thinking about opportunities where streaming can be cool. And also, you know, Danny is the chess.com guy, and you know, if he says streaming is the next big thing, then I believe him. And and I want to be a part of it. So I want to learn how to do the streams. My opponent is down to 15 seconds. I'm going to queen this pawn. I'm going to queen these pawns in some order. And finally, I can rest. Okay, so these pawns, supported by the rook behind, are gonna win itself, and I won my first game. Excellent. World Cup streaming should definitely do that. Yeah, I think it would be a good idea. Charge ad money for that suit. I should, yeah. But it's a good compliment. Thank you. Champions League tonight? Yeah, but the Champions League is going to finish in 45 minutes, so we're going to get more viewers in the last hour with also the decisive games. Predictions for the World Cup. I'm a big Aronian fan, so obviously I thought he was going to do great. It was his chance to qualify for the candidates. And then he lost today and got knocked out. So I'm actually pretty sad. It was a bad day for Aronian. Wait, round two starts. 10 seconds. Go. I can make my... Okay, so this is... Oh, this is actually a good guy. This is an international master from Germany. So here I might actually need to focus a bit. We'll play the Rui Lopez. He's playing really fast. And do you watch any Twitch streams? Yeah, I do actually. But mostly kind of as preparation for this. So I started watching Hutch. Who's supposed to be, you know, this big time streamer, and not to do advertising for the competition, but he's in this tournament as well. And yeah, I thought it looked fun. Also, I've been talking to Eric Hansen, and he's been doing this chess bra streaming thing for actually quite a while. So I'm thinking I can learn something from him. So my opponent is Christof Sielecki. That's good to know. Yeah, it's kind of difficult to concentrate on everything here. So as long as I don't blunder anything, I guess I should be reasonably happy about things. Okay, I'm gonna try something. Okay, I'm gonna try something now. Play a4. He's really attacking me with the pawns here on the queen side. So I should try to counter that. But I'm not sure that was very clever what I did. Yeah. Eric is half Norwegian, that is true. He does not speak Norwegian. But on the other hand, I don't know if he speaks Chinese either. He's really gotten accustomed to Canada. And those, well, he should have good genes for those winters. But other than that, we Norwegians have no claim to him. Yes, I am better than Eric in bullet. Yes. Okay, so I got him thinking for a really long time. So that's a success. The problem, of course, being that I don't think my position is very good. Maybe it's good. I don't know. Kind of do have time to take this one. Yeah, okay, so. And this is hanging. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna hope that he takes now on d5. Okay, he didn't do that. Okay, so I won a pawn. But he's winning a pawn back. That's not good. That's not good at all. Okay, so this is just gonna be an interesting game, I guess. Yeah, it was really cool when I beat Magnus. I was really enjoying that. I'm not sure it's gonna happen anytime soon again. so I'm gonna enjoy it. As long as it lasts. I'm not sure whether I'm being outplayed or if I'm outplaying him. But it's really close, somewhere in between. I might be outplaying him, actually. Yeah, because now I got some coordination with my pieces. And I got the bishop pair, which is nice. Good positional player often loses to tactics. That's too bad, because I'm not very good at tactics. But I'm hoping to do positional outplaying him. So sometimes you meet a guy who can do what you do, but he can do it better than you. So that's going to be my hope. Now, I'm not sure that was a good move. I don't know how to defend my... After he exchanges queens, I don't know how to defend my my pawn on a6. He's going to come back with the rook. And, yeah. That was really stupid of me. Really, really stupid. Was not clever. Okay. Okay. It turns out I played a brilliant move by pure desperation. So g4, trying to get the g pawn attacking. I don't know what I would have done if he had taken here on a6, but since he didn't do that, I'm gonna generate some pretty nasty attack, I think. Okay, I don't know how to... Oh, what to do? Come on. Slight panic going on. Okay, so one of the other things good about playing g4 is that I now have space for my king. So there's no back rank mate. But if he takes with the rook now, I'm actually in trouble. Take, take. Yeah, okay. Okay, so some tactic saved the day. So far, I'm gonna protect my bishop, but that seems a bit too much. I don't wanna do that, so I'll just go here. And I think it's a very close game, but I think this pawn on d4 is in trouble. So I'm gonna go after it. And he's gonna try to stop me. No, I'm gonna win this. Yeah. I'm gonna win this. Because now I'm getting my knight to e6, making a doubled attack on the two pawns. And yeah. Good. So I got the tactic, exchanging my rook for the two pieces, and then the two pieces are coordinating very well to get the last, let's say, pieces of the puzzle. Yeah, okay, I may have made that more difficult than what it should have been. Okay, so now we're going for this pawn. And as far as I can tell, I'm gonna get this pawn. And then I'm just gonna queen. Whew. Yeah, I do live off chess full time. I play tournaments myself. I do some actually commentary on Norwegian TV, and I do some teaching and lectures and so on. Rook check was a real blunder. Had this game. I'm not sure he had this game. I thought it was a really, really interesting game. I think my g4 move was kind of creative, getting some good play there. And yeah, actually, I wasn't sure how it was gonna go until I realized that I had this clever thing with giving my rook for the knight and then getting the pawn with the check afterwards. Institutions do you lecture for? Well, it's kind of more teaching at chess clubs. It's nothing more advanced than that. Best dressed guy. Thank you. Thank you so much. I don't think there's a prize for best game. For best dressed guy, unfortunately. It's 7 rounds. Well, I'm pretty happy about everybody saying I'm well dressed. I don't have to stay calm. Ivan. Yeah. So next round is going to start any moment. We can take a look at the games still going on. This is actually kind of funny. It's not funny because the guy just agreed to a draw. But this is good news for me. One of the favorites of the tournament, Dlugy, is... Yeah, I probably mispronounced that horrendously. But one of the tournament favorites actually lost half a point. So, Van Kampen is playing. I didn't really... He must have been cheating because I didn't see him on the participants list. Having, of course, prepared all my games, I'm gonna go for this Berlin. It's basically the only opening the Norwegian chess audience knows after Magnus used it so many times. Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on, to be honest. It's pretty drawish, I would say. We have a symmetrical pawn structure. And I made some moves without really knowing whether they were good. But I should be fine. I should be perfectly fine. Scandinavians played the Scandinavian. I actually did play the Scandinavian at some point, but I was young and I didn't know any better. I never realized how stressful it is to play against strong guys and actually have to say something clever at the same time. Okay, so I'm allowing him to put his bishop down there. I don't really mind because I'm chasing him back where he came from pretty soon. Hopefully. Yeah, okay, maybe he does have some pressure. Okay, I got it. That's a good move. That's a very good move. That's a very good move. I completely ruined his pawn structure, and I'm soaking up the pressure against on the e-file. So he's gonna play his bishop back to f4. And I should have a plan. Because then he's going to put his bishop on e5. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to exchange, and I'm going to play queen d7. And I'm so solid. It's not even funny. So solid. And then I'm bringing my rook into play. I ruined his pawn structure. Yeah, I got this. Come on. Okay, so we're exchanging pieces, but I'm kind of hoping that every exchange is helping me somehow. Because now I want to get at his king. I used a lot of my time, but I can afford it. And now I'm going to play this knight up to h4. And it's going to be awkward for him. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to win this game. He's reasonably solid already, but making moves like that is not really going to help his cause. Wasn't that just a huge blunder? Next move, I'm playing my queen up to h4. I mean, what is he thinking? Wow. Robin, what are you thinking? Yeah, no, this isn't looking very good. I think I'm going to win a pawn. And a pawn I can win a chess game with. Dancing, having loud music. I have a suit. That's correct. And I would have music, but number one, I'm slightly embarrassed about my taste in music. And also, I'm afraid I skimmed through some of the YouTube copyright infringement kind of thingies. And I got the impression that even if you were to sing a song yourself, you could get into trouble. So there's going to be no singing. There's going to be no YouTube videos streaming music. What's wrong with my taste in music? It's unorthodox. Let's put it like that. Unorthodox, yeah. No, I don't think there's anything wrong with it. But people, when kind of hearing it, starts giggling. Danny's always singing. Well, Danny maybe is not trying to get his videos out on YouTube afterwards. I don't know. Okay, so he made a move. And he gave me his pawn. Right? I mean, there's nothing wrong with this now. I can take with this one. I can take with that one. Let's just make it easy. Oh, I'm so good. I'm so good. Oh, shit. I'm so good. I thought I was being clever. Yeah. Okay, so he's threatening bishop d6. I saw that. I just thought I could play h4, h3, and give a checkmate. But if I play h4, he's just going to take it. So I should give some checks. Then just go back. Yeah, I messed it up big time. Big time. Maybe I didn't mess up so much. This is looking slightly promising. What are you doing? I'm not quite sure what the idea is. I'm hoping to get him to play King E1, and then I'm going back. Yeah, okay, this is just gonna be... Oh, come on. Yeah, I messed this up pretty bad. Yeah, really bad. I was completely winning. Completely winning. Yeah. And he got so lucky. Such a lucky. I might be still winning, actually. This looks like checkmate, no? Whew, that was a close one. Damn. Yeah, you can hear it in my breathing. I'm not really... Yeah. Very good. Checkmate it is. Bishop g3, good move. Stopping the king from getting up to f2. Yeah, it kind of did remind me of some games I've been winning and then messed it up, but it worked out well. Yeah, I'm stressed. And there's a new game coming up. Wow, Lenderman is playing. I had no idea. So it's actually really strong. And Meier. Ooh, yeah, it's gonna be a draw, presumably, because there's a nice kind of stopping the king from ever getting out, and it's a draw by repetition. Did you prepare against your opponents? I would like to say yes, but that would be untrue. I actually did not. So, yeah, it's actually really tough. I think both Van Kampen and Lenderman were not signed up. Okay, so Meier is playing an opening he has played many, many times. And yet I have no idea what to do. I think you're supposed to give this check after he plays b6. Not that I completely understand why. But now I'm going for his bishop. Oh shit. Okay, clearly he prepared this stuff, so I'm gonna assume that any tactics are not very good for me. And begs the question, what should I do? I don't really want to move my pawn here. Let's try moving the rook. And then I'll go with the bishop and play c3. And then I'll go queen b3. That looks solid. Bishop pair. I can work with that. So I should watch out for any knight g4 kind of things. And then the question is, should I exchange or should I try to get him to do that? I'm gonna take it and then just see what happens. So he's probably gonna play b5. Then I guess I'll go move my rook. I'm not sure I was too clever. His knight might actually be quite good here on the light squares. But I'm hoping that somehow I'll my position looks like a mess, no? You might want a moderator. That's interesting. I think I have one hiding in there somewhere. So don't think you can do anything you want. I don't see this game being anything other than a draw. But I'm gonna try to move quickly so that I don't lose on time. And then something, the brackets, that's the total amount of points we have in the tournament. So I actually have half a point more than Meier, which means draw is actually quite a good result for me. And now I'm gonna activate my other rook. And then I don't have a plan, but neither does he really. So it's all about not spending all of our time. Ah, he did have a plan. Interesting. Okay, so now I had to give up the f4 square. It's not looking fantastic, but I think I should be fine. Whenever I want, I can take this knight. So until then, I'm gonna try to keep him busy on both sides of the board. See what happens. Now I'm thinking about playing a4, so he's gonna stop me. And then I gotta think about something else. Yeah. Not much happening here. Okay, I'm gonna have to take this knight sooner or later, unfortunately. I'm gonna have to take it. I don't see any other way. But how am I gonna win a game then? Okay, sometimes you can't win, sometimes draw is the best you can get. So I'm gonna double my rooks. The knight was actually keeping my rook here on h1 out of play, because the rook always needed to protect the pawn. So by taking the knight, I'm kind of giving some more options to my rook. Damn, wow. Yeah, this is really not looking good. I'm getting outplayed. That's not good. Promising. Okay. This is really not good. Okay, case, I'm going to play my rook here, and then I'm going to play my rook here. And okay, I at this point, I was a bit undecided whether or not I wanted to draw, but at this point, I decided that a draw is the best I can do. So I'm going to just try to make a draw. I think I should manage. Magnus is actually a very good one-man player, but he just doesn't really have the opportunity to show it that often. Maybe I should take with my pawn and then do another exchange. I'll try that. I'm not sure better than Naka. Naka is a monster. Yeah, okay. I played this game horrendously, really. But I think I'm gonna make a draw. I beat him in beach volleyball. He's not that good in beach volleyball. Okay, now he's actually gonna have to take the draw, because he's running out of time as well. So that was a pretty poor white game, but it's a draw. So there's that, I didn't lose. That's also always something good. Wow, he's actually still trying. Maybe I should be careful. Wow, he's actually still trying. And I'm actually making it difficult for myself. No. Yeah, now I'm getting the bishop back into play. Now I'm taking his pawn. Hey, hold on. Now I don't want to draw. I'm a pawn up. No draw. And he's down in time. 10 seconds left. This was a pretty strange turn of events. Okay, he's going for this pawn. That's interesting. I should stop that, probably. Yeah, okay. Well, it's not like I was winning anyway. Okay, so he's trying to get at this pawn, and that would be a problem for me. So I don't see how I can let him take that one. Let's just make the draw. Let's not have any accidents. Okay, you're gonna play on with a pawn down and a less time on the clock. That's brave. It's not so brave when I blunder everything. Wow, that was poor. Wow. That was insanely poor. Wow. Sometimes you get so amazed at your ability to play poorly. Wow. Wow, I actually did manage to make life difficult. And now I can't stop. What's going on? What happened? Wow, he lost the time. What did I miss? I must have missed so many things. I wanted time. But I mean, I was a pawn up in this final position. I'm actually losing that pawn on h3. And then he's getting a passed pawn on h4. That was so sick. He must have lost his internet connection or something. Yeah, maybe he did forget the time control. That's just sick. And it's really sick that I managed to blunder the position. I mean, if we go back a couple moves, I mean, I should be making a draw easily here. If anything, he was the one blundering a pawn, right? But this f3 move is actually interesting. He forced me to play f3 because now I no longer can guard this pawn from the side. And that actually made it a bit difficult for me because every time he was trying to get back into here, getting this pawn, I had no good way of defending that. So I was doing fine with the repetition up to here. And then he just decided not to do the repetition. And I thought, okay, I'll try to win. But I should have gone back with my bishop. Because instead I just played rook e4 and after this move, threatening both the bishop and the pawn. Yeah. Yeah, that was some kind of a miracle. The pawn down position, if we go back to how it should have been, yeah, I think I'm in trouble. Yeah, I think I would have lost this. Probably. Because it's a passed pawn, and it's guarded with this very strong bishop getting down here. Yeah, so that was a strange way to end the game. There's one game remaining in the round. There's Shahedi playing black. Has a pawn up. I would think it's a draw. But these knights can be really tricky, especially when you're low on time. So these guys are going to be playing for a while. Have I played any of these players over the board? Yes, I have. I think I've played against Robin van Kampen, the guy I beat in the previous round. I definitely played against, actually, maybe I didn't. Maybe I actually never played either Meier or van Kampen, but I've been at the same tournaments at least. Who do you dislike more? Yeah, that's gonna be... Let's see, what's the command, right? Time out. Stingio. Yeah. Sorry about that. Still going on, the pawn is still alive, but I really don't see how. Wow, that's a tricky move. And that's a tricky move. That's very nice. With the stalemate motive. And now he should just check and go back. my favorite chess book, Seven Deadly Chess Sins, by Rosen. Rosen? Vaillé's performance. I thought, oh wow, he actually managed to lose. Wow. No. No, no, it's a loss. Because always when you get the king on the sixth rank, it's a win. Regardless who's to move. So now you just go g3. Right? No, maybe not. Maybe you have to go to h3. Yeah, precisely. Ah, that's very good. Good technique from Shahedi. He does the US chess schools, teaching the juniors endgames. So he should know this stuff. Name a couple of more chess books. I like Yermolinsky. Yermolinsky with... what was the name of the book? The Road to Chess Improvement. I thought it was interesting. My System, I never read. I have it, but I never read it. G3 would have been a draw. I don't know about that. Vaillé in the World Cup. I thought it was a fantastic match he had today. Because in the tiebreak, well, every single game, they were winning and losing. So Vaillé was losing and then winning. And it was an exciting game, an exciting match. So next game against Maxim Dlugy. And I'm going to have to focus. Because I guess if I win this one, I'm basically winning the tournament. So I'm just going to do the normal things, controlling the center and all of that stuff. This is a funny opening. Because now I'm just gonna, I think, do this. Then we're kind of both stuck, not doing anything constructive. This knight. Yeah, okay, it does look like he kind of feels like he knows what he's doing, and I have no clue. So let's move a bit faster. He's supposed to be one of these blitz experts, and he's trying to get some attack going towards my king. And I'm slightly nervous about that, because it's looking dangerous to me. It's looking very dangerous. Oh, damn. Would be a shame just to lose without ever really getting into the game. That would be depressing. What to do? Oh my gosh. Just have to make a move, I guess. However depressing. And this is one of those made at home stuff, and I just fell completely for it. Just letting him waltz over me. That's pretty much something to be ashamed of. Wow, that was poor. It's really poor. Oh my god. Okay, so I'm just gonna have to give up this exchange and hope for the best. And I'm not sure why I played c4. Probably I would have done so much better without making this random move. But at some point I had to do something, because I was just letting him win so easily. Ugh. And now he got the bishop as well. I was kind of going to use that bishop for something. Yeah. This is not my game. And now he's just going to take that one as well. Oh my gosh. That was poor. That was shameful. Oh well. There's going to be more games. Preferably some games where I don't play as poorly as I just did. Opening on the queen side, and there's pretty much nothing I can do. Ridiculous. I didn't really give him much of a challenge, did I? Not much of a challenge at all. That was tragic. Well, it had to happen sooner or later. Dlugy is playing, then he's streaming. He should be streaming. I don't know his Twitch. But he's probably having a lot of fun right now. I don't want to think about it. Yeah, that's sad. Lose this position with both colors. No, you would not. What's my opinion on Mickey Adams? I really like Mickey. I think he's one of the good guys. I spent some time with him for the World Championship match. He was one of Magnus's seconds. But even before that, I felt like he was a really strong player and someone you should try to imitate if you could. A new book on the Nimso? No, I haven't. Okay, I'm fighting. I think I'm gonna play my rook king out here. Well, basically he can win any way he wants, and that's his problem. Because any way he wants means that he needs actually to decide which way he wants to play. And that can be actually annoying at times, deciding how to win. I'm still alive, and I'm trying to get this h2 pawn. And I'm guessing he's pretty nervous about me getting that h2 pawn, because he's played really poorly. He let me back into the game. Now I did something not too clever as well. Yeah. I should have stopped rook d1. I should have stopped it, but I didn't. Okay. So I'm going to block this d pawn with my bishop, and then I'm going to use my king somehow, annoying him. Going for the rook. Now I actually got this pawn if I want. And now I got some counterplay with a pawn of my own. And he's gonna be annoyed that he hasn't won this yet. Cause soon I'm gonna be making some threats against him. That was a poor move. And he knew it. Oh fuck. Yeah, sorry. Oh my god. Yeah, okay. I fought well, but then I just made this horrendous blunder. I don't know what I was thinking. Yeah. That was pretty sick. I shouldn't be... I actually fought well. I was almost making a draw at this point. Because he was spending so much time and didn't figure out what to do. If I just had made some other move here, instead of going with my bishop... If I had played like rook d6. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, rook d6. Instead, this bishop. Let's check. Yeah, that was pretty sick. Dlugy is streaming and no commenting. And no face. No face. That's interesting. That actually, if he doesn't have a face, he's not eligible for the prizes, which makes it even more silly that I lost against him. But that was a really poor opening. So it turns out the opening does matter, and you shouldn't let your opponent attack for free. You shouldn't let them get streaming with face and comment. So then why was somebody saying something else? Is talking. Yeah, I would think so. And I would guess he had a lot of fun. Because that was a horrendous game. And, well, he was probably stressed after a while. But, yeah, that was not good. Okay, Lenderman, and we have the same amount of points. That's interesting. Yeah, I'm gonna have to get back from that. That was a really poor game. But now we have an opening I know, an opening I have played many, many times. But it's been a couple of years since I played this, so I don't actually remember what I'm supposed to do. Something about getting my queen to f6. h4, wow. Well, I don't care too much about that. I'm gonna place my bishop here. French defense not played that often on top level. I don't know, but one of the main French guys, French guys, the guys who play French, is Georg Meier. So maybe you're watching the wrong stream. Because he actually played the French against me, so he's doing it quite often. And yeah, he's, I guess you would have to say, the best guy doing the French on a regular basis. Lenderman is not a streamer. No, this is the first. Well, I'm not a streamer normally. I'm trying out for the first time now. It's working okay, except for the fact that I lost a horrendous game last round, and the fact that I'm a pawn down right now. So I'm, you know, still getting used to it. Oh, this could get really ugly for me. I don't like being a pawn down, to be honest. Comment about the English opening. I have a lot of viewers. Thank you, I guess. The thing is that there's a prize for who has the most viewers. And there's this regular streamer, Hutch. And he's got even more viewers than I do. So I'm not winning any prizes that way. I have no idea. Yeah, I'm starting to get quite a bit of respect for these guys who keep streaming and commenting on their games all the time. Because it's not easy to focus while talking and trying to make sense to a crowd. Better than all my opponents. That's fantastic. That's what I like to hear. But having said that, the main prize is actually winning chess games. So when I'm a minute down on the clock and not doing very well on the board, I'm a pawn down. He has a bishop pair. I have some attacking chances against the king. So that's good. That's very good. And now I got some ideas how to get to this f4 square. Oh my god. And I blundered bishop c4. Okay. He didn't care. Then I'm gonna go here. Oh, now this is looking good. I'm attacking the bishop and then the pawn is hanging behind it. Oh, this is very good. See the leaderboard. I don't know. It's probably at chess.com, the live chess center. I have 4 points. And I'm not sure. I don't think anybody else has more than 4 points. So probably I had a full point lead when I lost this horrendous game in the last round. But I've played most of the very good guys. This is actually... Alex is basically the last GM I haven't played. So if I win this game, I'm looking really good. So he's going to have to move his bishop to like g3. Then I'm going to take on here on f3. He's going to move his rook to g1 and create some threats down towards my king. And I'm actually not too happy about that. But okay, he castled. That's interesting. I'm going to move my knight here. I'm just going to take this pawn. I mean, there are no points for style. I should just take a pawn whenever I can. Or maybe there are points for style. I'll try this move instead. So now I'm forcing the bishop away, and then I'm going to capture the pawn on... on e4. He might actually play bishop f1. What's my plan then? Yeah, no, he's not. So I got this pawn. That's a very nice central pawn, and he's very low on time. If I play my cards right now, I'm gonna win this game. Easily. I'm gonna win this game easily. Ah, I got a trick. He's gonna fall for it. I tell you. Yeah. Ah! Nothing like a good trick. And the knight gets back to win the knight. That's excellent. And he's gonna resign. Because he's low on time. There's nothing going on. He's a piece down. And I'm gonna win. Yeah. And now there's a nice checkmate. F4, rook e6, and g6. What a bit. He could have gone for it. He's gonna lose anyway. Yeah. Okay, my technique here is not fantastic. It should be enough. Somehow. Yeah, I can take that rook, no? Yeah, grandmasters are not really that good. We do make mistakes as well. I just let Maxim take my bishop the last round, and now he gave away a rook. So that's good. And we're done with the, in theory, most difficult guys. Okay, so far so good. Horrendous game against Dlugy. Yeah, somebody's gonna have to help me with the pronunciation of that. But other than that, it's, well, I said people overestimate grandmasters. I mean, we're not like, we're still humans. And we make mistakes. Here illustrated by, here illustrated by Alex. Just giving his rook away. Study tactics. I tried to study tactics, yeah. But I look more at openings. Why don't you make more shocking sacrifices? Because there aren't any. I mean, this was an attacking game. I mean, I was creating attack against his king. I just, you know, I didn't have to sacrifice a piece to get there. I just had to sacrifice a pawn. How did it feel to beat Carlsen in Norway chess? It felt pretty good. It felt pretty good. Any other comments we should take a look at? Have I been invited to see pawn sacrifice? Actually, I've been invited to the premiere here in Oslo. So that's going to be interesting. And now I'm playing against an IM, John Bartholomew, yeah, something. So he's pretty good as well. He's playing the Scandinavian. Somebody was asking about that. And let's see what happens. Yeah, Meier's loss against me was tough, right? I mean, he lost on a technicality. Probably his internet connection broke or something. So that's, yeah. Tough luck. I'm gonna actually let him try to be aggressive here on the queen side, because I think I can counter, and then there's going to be some weaknesses in his camp that I can exploit later on. So now I have this nice square on c4 where I can place my knight. I really think he should have stopped that. I think he should have gone something like with the knight up here. But when he didn't do that, I'm just gonna... Yeah, okay. I'm gonna try something a bit unorthodox here. I'm gonna play this pawn so that this guy is a bit lonely, and then I'm gonna put my bishop here actually. I don't really know if I'm better, probably not. But he's taking his time, which is nice. Nice for me, at least. I'm not sure he should play e5, because then it opens the diagonal for the bishop towards the black king. But it really seems like he's intent on playing e5. And I'm not gonna stop him. I'm gonna let him do that. So now, next order of business, get the bishop out. And I'm gonna go up here. Ooh, did I just blunder a pawn? I did. Wow, that's not good. And that's so not paying attention. Yeah. Okay. Well, I'll survive. Okay. I like my pawns, so I'm gonna just try to protect it like this. I'm seeing a tactic now involving me taking on f6 and then doing some stuff. But taking on f6, he can probably just take back. Okay, I think I messed up pretty bad there, but I think he missed his opportunity, and now I'm feeling okay about my position again. And I think I'm gonna keep this bishop. Might come in handy later in the game. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Okay, so now the knight is going to d4, and that's actually kind of annoying. So I'm gonna try to exchange my bishop for the knight before the knight becomes so powerful that I can't really do anything about it. And he's gonna take here on g3, and I'm gonna take towards the center, because that's what they taught me when I was a kid. Shit, he has b3. Okay, he didn't see b3, so I'm gonna take the opportunity to stabilize the pawn structure, and then he's gonna go here. Okay, I'm playing really poorly this game, I think. But here's my plan. I'm gonna just protect this pawn, make sure I don't lose it, and then I'm gonna checkmate him on the king side, and I'm gonna play so fast that he's gonna get all stressed out and have no idea what's going on. It's not looking good. It's not looking good. I'm kind of hoping he doesn't go to g5, but he did. Now I'm gonna do something slightly desperate. Oh, knight f5, I missed. Wow. Shit. Yeah. Okay. This is not This is not according to plan. What to say? And I'm not really playing that fast either. I can't really flag him. Kind of difficult to flag people with this time control as well. Nah, I'm just completely dominated. It's pretty sad. I'm getting hammered. Excuse the pun. Yeah. Okay, so defense. It's all about the defense now. Okay, so I'm still alive. Still breathing, if only barely. And he's gotten aggressive, which I don't really mind because he's pretty low on time. But he's being aggressive in a way that it's not so easy to punish him. And now I'm low on time as well. That's just, you know, great. That's just great. Everything is going so great. Yeah. Now I might as well just resign. Tragedy, this is. Just complete disaster. Yeah, that was not good. Okay, maybe I can trick him somehow. It's not so easy for him to make progress. So long as he's low on time, I think I got a fighting chance. Now I'm actually making a draw. Wow, I'm making a draw. I should be making a draw. If I don't make a draw now, I'm gonna be upset. Really upset. That pawn I'm gonna take. At this point, I'm not sure I even want to draw. Yeah, I played that too fast. How to be the maximum amount of tricky. Actually, it's not a draw instantly. That was pretty bad. Okay. So that was an undeserved draw. I thought for a slight moment there I could play for a win. He was getting really low on time and I was threatening a fork. Threatening a fork here, getting the king and rook. But he played knight c5, trying to get a fork of his own with my king and rook. And I was trying to find something good here, but... Yeah, honestly, I thought maybe you were winning that tactic at the end. I was winning, maybe. Somebody's saying I won on tiebreak? That sounds unlikely, because there's one more game, right? What's wrong with the classic tank top? I don't have the body for it. It was the last round. Wow! It was the last round, and I'm a winner, it says. Let's move that into the screen. Can everybody see that? Number one, Sultan of Kings on tiebreak. Wow, we did 7 rounds already? I was ready for so much more fun. Meier is second. Meier, who lost against me, who should have, well, should probably have won that game. At the very least, he should have made a draw. And I think he disconnected. I'll try to figure that out, but I think he disconnected. And yeah, he should have won the tournament. I did. I'm very happy about that. I had a very interesting game against Van Kampen early on. And I see on the chat now, Meier is saying he had a bad lag, so that's unfortunate for him. He would have won the tournament otherwise. And yeah, I guess that was chess.com's streamer challenge. Wow. So everybody, there's gonna be a voting on chess.com as to who was your favorite streamer of the tournament. So I'm gonna use this moment to selflessly promote myself. Well, shamelessly promote myself as the best streamer of the tournament. I say this, of course, knowing that I haven't watched a single of the other streams, yeah, I'm feeling good about myself, and you ought to do that, right? My vote, that's great. I would like to hear I get a lot of your votes at I think a chess.com poll starting tomorrow. Yeah, this really was 7 rounds. I'm ready for some more chess. There will be a poll on the front page for fan favorite. I'm gonna ask when is the poll. Because, I mean, I would like you to vote immediately, right? did I promise to play bullet chess with Eric Hansen? I don't think I did make that promise. YouTube channel. I have started a YouTube channel. And I'm gonna post the streaming videos I do, and hopefully some other stuff as well. But I don't have it ready quite yet. I think I have a link somewhere, but it's like I don't have the kind of shorthand cool link YouTube / Jon Ludvig or something like that. I have these random letters, random numbers, so I have no idea what my YouTube is. Putting up the poll tomorrow morning, so they actually force you to sleep on it, and you can't vote until you start thinking about, did I really think Hammer was the best one? Yeah, I hope so. Somebody's stalking me on Twitter and Facebook. That's very nice. I stalk a lot of other people on, I don't stalk people on Twitter. I stalk people on Facebook. For best stream, yeah, the best stream. So if you think this is the best stream, this is the best stream, then you vote for me tomorrow at chess.com, the front page.